And here's a live picture this evening from our PWC Pennant Building camera at Ballpark Village as we check in again with meteorologist Angela Huddy. Angela, today into tomorrow, the culmination of a busy week of work in the Weather Center for you and the rest of our team of meteorologists. We're seeing moisture already in our area, more rain, but as you mentioned earlier, Jeff Bernthal seeing some to our north.
And that is where our eyes go, and now it's a sort of a waiting game for temperatures to get cold enough to get that transition over to snow. This heavy snow will overcome some borderline temperatures, so 33, 34 degrees could be cold enough to start to see a few snowflakes mixing in. Check out the view here from the couple of our web cameras. Starting to see wet conditions, Moscow Mills and Eckerd's as well. Farmington, look, we have the rain coming down there as well. Now that the views are a little darker, a little harder for me to make them out, but we have rain that is pushed east of the Mississippi River now and is pushing towards that I-57 corridor. So if you're from say central parts of Montgomery County down into Perry County, Illinois, and off to the east there, you're still dry for now, but it is on the way. What else is on the way is this snow that is off to our north. We are starting to see some indications as well of a little mixing maybe beginning to go on in our northernmost counties from central Lincoln, or excuse me, Lincoln County, Pike County here. This is the 61 corridor here. Here's 54. So that area there, right around Bowling Green, maybe starting to see a little bit of a mix. That mix also starting to take hold in parts of Green. Jersey County, if you're in the Jerseyville or Philden area, you might be seeing a few snowflakes right now. Verdon down to Litchfield, maybe also starting to see a little mixing of that precipitation. South of there, it's a cold rain that is coming down here in Metro St. Louis. I was just down in it. I can promise you it is a cold rain, but just wet conditions for now. We also have some poor visibility in spots as the cloud deck has lowered. We've got those visibility numbers that have dropped to less than 2 miles in spots, especially up along Interstate 55 towards that Litchfield area. So keep that in mind. That's going to be another factor out there tonight. Lots of clouds, the wet conditions transitioning to that snow. And as you heard Jamie Travers mention a little earlier, they can't pre-treat with this rain. It'll wash it away. So those road crews will have to get out as that transition takes hold and get that treatment down on the pavement. It's wet in Waterloo, Illinois, and it is wet in Eureka, Missouri, our view from Jellystone Park here. And we'll go ahead next to our cameras here in Maryland Heights. This is our roof camera view here, looking down on the wet conditions there. 29 degrees, our wind chill with an east wind at 8, really at 35 degrees. So just holding above the freezing point right there. East winds are at 8, pressure 30.1 inches, and it is currently rising. Temperatures today did get all the way to 45 degrees with some peaks of sunshine this afternoon. 30 the low this morning. You can really make out the fog, the low clouds hanging over Lambert Airport as the rain falls down tonight. Temperatures elsewhere, wet conditions in Cuba, Missouri. And I take you to Cuba because look at this pocket of slightly warmer air. Low 40s, Cuba, Rolla, Potosi. So it'll be a little later of a transition along that I-44 corridor from rain to snow because we're holding on to that warmer air. But it will be working its way southward as we go through the overnight. By about 2 o'clock in the morning, just about everyone but that southwest corner is seeing snow, and it's all snow by wake up time Saturday morning. But notice we're starting to end things already to the north. We'll see all the snow come to an end around lunchtime tomorrow, and then it is cloudy, it is cold, and it is windy. With wind gusts tomorrow around 25 miles per hour, we could see wind chills tomorrow holding in the upper teens and low 20s. I still like 2 to 4 inches across the bulk of the St. Louis area. Got a little compression going on, so those numbers may be on the 2 to 3 side. A little bit less the more that you go to the east. Towards I-57, 1 to 2 inches of snow is expected. That transitioned to all snow tonight, and then snow overnight. And again, through about lunchtime tomorrow, we'll wake up near 31, only see high temperatures that are near that 33 degree mark tomorrow afternoon. So keep that in mind. Windy and cold. We'll get the sunshine back on Sunday, but not much of a warm up, 32. Monday, then we will start a little bit of warm up. And how about we're back near 50 by Tuesday?